Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. And this is Module 3, Second Law of Thermodynamics, Lecture number 308, Third Module, Second Law of Thermodynamics, Lecture number 8. And we recap from the previous lectures. So in the previous lectures, we discussed the Carnot cycle, heat engine and the efficiency of the heat engine cycle, Carnot cycle, refrigerator, heat pump and the COP of the refrigerator and heat pump. In the earlier lecture 307, 306, we solved a few problems on the above topic, refrigerator, heat pump, efficiency of the heat engine, and we continue with the problems. In this lecture also, we solve additional problems on the second law of thermodynamics from various un-university question papers. The learning outcome for the today's lecture, the student will be able to solve problem on the second law of thermodynamics. So this is example number 13 from un-university examination, May 2019. A Carnot heat engine draws heat from a reservoir at a temperature 600 degrees Celsius and reject heat to another reservoir at a temperature T3. The Carnot forward cycle engine drives Carnot refrigerator, which absorbs heat from the reservoir at a temperature 300 Kelvin and rejects heat to the reservoir at temperature T3. Determine 1. The temperature T3 such that heat supplied to the engine Q1 is equal to heat absorbed by the refrigerator Q2. The efficiency of the Carnot engine and the COP of the refrigerator. So we have a heat engine which is taking heat from a temperature, the reservoir at temperature 600 Kelvin and reject the heat to the sink at temperature T3. And the refrigerator is here. So the refrigerator is driven by the heat engine, and the refrigerator, it takes heat energy from the reservoir at refrigerator space at 300 Kelvin and reject heat to the temperature T3. So T4, T3, they are equal. Now the condition for the problem, T3 equal to T4 and Q1 equal to Q2. So the heat given to the heat engine is equal to heat extracted by the refrigerator. So the efficiency of the heat engine, eta equal to T1 minus T3 divided by T1. So the higher temperature minus lower temperature divided by the higher temperature, which is W by Q1. So W equal to work done. Work output of the heat engine W equal to T1 minus T3 divided by T1 into Q1. So Q1 is the amount of heat supplied to the heat engine cycle. Now for the refrigerator, COP equal to the desired effect Q2 divided by Q2 minus Q4. So COP equal to T2 by T4 minus T2, which is equal to T2 by T4 equal to T3. So T3 minus T2 into is, which is equal to Q2 by double heat extracted by the work input. Now the COP of this refrigerator, COP equal to Q2 by, we substitute for W from the previous equation, T1 minus T3 divided by T1 into Q1. So COP is, the COP equal to Q2 by Q1, this Q2 divided by this Q1 into, this will go to the numerator. So T1 divided by T1 minus T3. So we take the reciprocal and multiply the equation, T1 by T1 minus T3. Now the condition for the problem, Q1 equal to Q2. So using the Q1 equal to Q2, that is getting cancelled. T2 by T3 minus T2 equal to T1 by T1 minus T3. Substituting the temperature, T2 equal to 300 Kelvin. So 300 divided by T3 minus 300. T1 equal to 600 Kelvin. So 600 divided by 600 minus T3. So solving this equation, we will get T3 equal to 400 Kelvin. Now the efficiency of the heat engine, eta equal to T1 minus T2 divided by T1 equal to 34%, and the COP of the refrigerator equal to COP equal to T3 by T4 minus T3 equal to 300 divided by 400 minus 300 equal to 3. So the answer to the problem, the temperature T3 equal to 400 Kelvin, the efficiency of the heat engine, Carnot heat engine is 34%, and the efficiency of the COP equal to COP of the refrigerator equal to 3. And we take one more example. A heat engine operating between two reservoirs, 1000 Kelvin and 300 Kelvin, is used to drive a heat pump which extracts heat from a reservoir at 300 Kelvin and at a rate twice at which engine rejects heat to it. If the efficiency of the engine is 40% of the maximum possible value, possible, and the COP of the heat pump is 50% of the maximum possible, make calculation for the temperature of the reservoir to which heat pump rejects the heat energy. Also work out the rate of heat rejection from the heat pump if the rate of heat supplied to the engine is 50 kilowatts. So we have a heat engine here, so which is working between 1000 Kelvin and 300 Kelvin. The amount of heat given to the heat engine is 50 kilowatts. The heat engine is driving the heat pump, which is taking heat energy from temperature from the source at temperature 300 Kelvin and supply heat to the T3. So Q3 is the heat supplied to the reservoir at T3. Now the question is, we have to calculate what is T3, what is the amount of heat supplied and heat rejected by the heat pump. So the condition is Q4 equal to 2 times of Q2. So the Q4 equal to 2 times of heat rejected by the heat engine. Actual efficiency of the heat engine is 40% of the Carnot efficiency and actual COP of the heat pump is 50% of the Carnot COP. This is what the condition given in the problem. Now we calculate the efficiency of the heat engine. 1 minus T2 by T1 equal to 1 minus 300 by 1000 equal to 0.7. The actual efficiency of the heat engine is 0.4 times of Carnot efficiency. So 0.4 into 0.7 equal to 0.28. So from the efficiency definition, W by Q1, we calculate W equal to eta A into Q1, which is 0.28 into 50 equal to 14 kilowatts. And W equal to Q1 minus Q2, so we calculate Q2 equal to Q1 minus W equal to 50 minus 14 equal to 36 kilowatts. So this is the calculation for heat engine cycle. Now for the COP of the heat pump, so W equal to Q3 minus Q4. So what we are given, Q4 equal to 2 times of Q2. So W, this work is given to the heat pump, so 36 equal, work done W equal to 14 equal to Q3 minus 2 times of 36, so Q3 equal to 86 kilowatts. So heat rejected, heat rejected by the heat pump Q3 equal to 86 kilowatts. And COP of the actual COP of the heat pump, that is equal to Q3 by W, so 86 divided by 14 equal to 6.14. So the actual COP of the heat pump, so this is the heat pump, the actual COP is 6.14. Now the Carnot COP equal to actual COP divided by 50. So the actual COP is 50% of Carnot COP, so 0.5. So the Carnot COP is 12.28. Now the Carnot COP is given by T3 by T3 minus T4. So 12.28 equal to T3 by T3 minus 300. So the temperature T3 equal to 326.6 Kelvin. So the answer to the problem, temperature of the reservoir to which heat pump rejects heat equal to T3 equal to 326.6 kilowatts. The rate of heat rejection from the heat pump equal to 86 kilowatts. Q3 equal to 86 kilowatts and T3 equal to 326.6 Kelvin. And we take the next problem, problem number 15 from Anna University question paper, November 2019. Now we have the heat engine in series. So the two Carnot engine works in series between source and sink temperature 550 Kelvin and 350 Kelvin. If both engines develop equal power, draw the schematic and label them properly and also determine the intermediate temperature. So this is the reservoir at the 550 Kelvin and this is the heat engine 1, which takes heat energy from the reservoir Q1 and it produces work W1. And it rejects Q2 is the amount of heat energy rejected by the heat engine with the temperature T2. Now the heat output, the rejection from the first engine, it is given to the second engine. Second engine produces work W2 and rejects heat energy Q3 to the reservoir of temperature 350 Kelvin. Now the question is, we have to calculate what is the intermediate temperature, the condition given in the problem W1 equal to W2. So you draw the diagram, write down the condition and we will solve the problem. We just use the efficiency of the heat engine cycle and solve the problem. So W1 equal to W2, that is what the given in the problem. So W1 equal to W2, so W1 equal to Q1 minus Q2, W2 equal to Q2 minus Q3. So in the left hand side, you take Q2 outside, so Q1 by Q2 minus 1. In the right hand side, we take Q2 outside, so Q2 into 1 minus Q3 by Q2. So Q2, Q2 getting cancelled and this becomes Q1 by Q2 equal to T1 by T2 minus 1, 1 minus Q3 by Q2 equal to T3 by T2 and rearranging T1 by T2 plus T3 by T2 equal to 2 and 550 divided by T2 plus 350 divided by 2 T2 equal to 2 and T2 equal to 450 Kelvin. So solving this equation, the intermediate temperature equal to 450 Kelvin. So the answer to the problem, intermediate temperature T2 equal to 450 Kelvin. And again, the engine is series. Two reversible heat engines A and B are arranged in series. Engine A is rejecting heat directly to B. Engine A receives 200 kilojoules at a temperature of 421 degrees Celsius from a hot source, while B is in communication with the cold sink at temperature 4.4 degrees Celsius. If the work of A is twice of B, so WA equal to 2 times of WB. Find out the intermediate temperature between A and B, the efficiency of the each engine, heat rejected to the cold sink. So this is from the unanalyzed question paper, May 2018, November 2012. So engine A, the amount of heat supplied to the engine A is 200 kilojoules from a source at temperature of 421 degrees Celsius. And engine B is in contact with the sink at temperature of 4.4 degrees Celsius. Now the task is, you have to calculate the intermediate temperature, efficiency of the heat each engine and amount of heat rejected Q3. So the T1 equal to 421 degrees Celsius, which is 694 Kelvin, T3 equal to 4.4 degrees Celsius, which is 277.4 Kelvin. The condition to the problem is WA equal to 2 times of WB. So work produced by the engine A equal to 2 times of the work produced by the engine B. So WA equal to 2 times of WB. So we substitute WA equal to Q1 minus Q2 is equal to 2 into Q2 minus Q3. If we take Q2 outside from the left side, Q1 by Q2 minus 1. So here 2 into Q2 into 1 minus Q3 by Q2. So deleting the Q2, T1 by T2 minus 1 is equal to 2 into 1 minus T2 by T3 by T2. And substituting T1 by T2 plus 2 times of T3 by T2 equal to 3. So 694 divided by T2 plus 2 into 277.4 divided by T2 equal to 3. And solving this equation, the temperature T2 equal to 416.3 Kelvin. The efficiency of the heat engines, eta A, efficiency of the engine A equal to 1 minus T2 by T1, which is equal to 1 minus 416.2 divided by 694 equal to 0.4, which is 40%. The efficiency of the heat engine B equal to 1 minus T3 by T2, which is equal to 1 minus 277.4 divided by 416.3, is equal to 0.334 equal to 33.4%. And the heat rejected to the cold sink. So, eta A, definition of eta A. So, this Q2 equal to Q1 minus eta A into Q1, which is 200 minus 0.4 into 200 equal to 120 kilojoules. From the definition of eta B, Q2 minus Q3 divided by Q2, where Q3 equal to Q2 minus eta B into Q2, this equal to 120 minus 0.334 into 120 equal to 79.92 kilojoules. So the amount of heat rejected to the cold sink equal to 79.92 kilojoules. So the answer to the problem, intermediate temperature between A and B is 416.3 Kelvin. The efficiency of the engine eta A equal to 40%, eta B equal to 33.4%, and the heat rejected to the cold sink equal to 79.92 kilojoules. And we take example number 17. Now there are three heat engines in series. If three Carnot engines of same efficiency connected in series, such that the 1200 Kelvin reservoir supplies 2400 kilojoules of heat and 150 Kelvin reservoir receives 300 kilojoules of heat. Find out the intermediate temperature and efficiency and the work output of all the engines. This is from the unionized question paper, November 2018. So there are heat engines, engine 1, engine 2, engine 3. So work produced by engine 1 is W1, W2 and W3. Q1, the heat given to the first engine from the hot reservoir is 2400 kilojoules, and the Q4, the heat rejected by the third engine to the cold sink equal to 300 kilojoules. Now we have to calculate the intermediate temperature T2 and T3, efficiency and the work output of all the engines. So the condition given here, all the efficiency are equal. So the Carnot engine of same efficiency. So efficiency eta1 equal to eta2 equal to eta3. Now efficiency of the engine eta1, eta equal to 1 minus Q2 by Q1, eta equal to 1 minus Q3 by Q2 and eta equal to 1 minus Q4 by Q3. So from all the definition of efficiency of the first engine, second engine, third engine, Q2 by Q1 equal to 1 minus eta, Q3 by Q2 equal to 1 minus eta, Q4 by Q3 equal to 1 minus eta. So now using the three terms, you multiply all the three terms. So Q2 by Q1 into Q3 by Q2 into Q4 by Q3 equal to 1 minus eta to the power 3. So you look at this equation, Q2 is cancelled, Q3 is cancelled. So in the left hand side, Q4 by Q1 is left out. So Q4 by Q1 equal to 1 minus eta to the power 3. So Q4, that is Q4 is 300 and Q1 equal to 2400. So 300 by 2400 equal to 1 minus eta to the power 3. So this eta equal to 0.5. So efficiency of the all the engine is 0.5, that is 50%. Now intermediate temperature, eta equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. So T2 by T1 equal to 1 minus 0.5 equal to 0.5. So T2 equal to 0.5 times of T1 equal to 0.5 into 1200. Which is 600 Kelvin. Again, eta equal to 1 minus T3 by T2 for the second engine. So, T3 by T2 equal to 1 minus 0.5 equal to 0.5. So, T3 equal to 0.5 in T2, which is 0.5 into 600 equal to 300 Kelvin. So, T3 equal to 300 Kelvin and T2 equal to 600 Kelvin. Okay. Now, intermediate heat transfer. So, 1 minus eta equal to 1 minus Q2 by Q1. So, Q2 by Q1 equal to 1 minus eta. So, Q2 equal to Q1, 1 minus eta into Q1, which is 0.5 into 2400. So, Q2 equal to 1200 kilojoules. Again, eta equal to 1 minus Q3 by Q2. So, Q3 by Q2 equal to 1 minus eta. Now, Q3, amount of heat given to the third engine, Q3 equal to 1 minus eta into Q2, which is 0.5 into 1200, which is 600 kilojoules. So, work done. So, eta W1 equal to eta into Q1, 0.5 into 1200 kilojoules. W2 is equal to eta into Q2, which is 0.5 into 1200, which is 600 kilojoules. And W3 equal to eta into Q3, which is 0.5 into 600 equal to 300 kilojoules. So, work done. Intermediate heat transfer and intermediate temperature of all the heat engine cycles. Now the answer, intermediate temperatures are T2 equal to 600 Kelvin, T3 equal to 300 Kelvin. Efficiency of all the heat engine is 50%. Work output of all the engines, W1 equal to 1200 kilojoules, W2 equal to 600 kilojoules and W3 equal to 300 kilojoules. So these are all the answers to the problem. And we have one more example on the heat engine series, heat 3 Carnot engine in series ABC. 3 Carnot engines ABC working between temperatures 1000 Kelvin and 300 Kelvin are in a series combination. The work produced by these engines are in the ratio of 5:4:3. Make calculation of temperature of intermediate reservoir, and this is from unionized question paper May 2015. So, engine 1, engine 2, engine 3. The source temperature is 1000 Kelvin. The sink temperature is 300 Kelvin. So, intermediate temperatures are T2, T3 and W1, W2, W3 are work output of the each engine. The condition given here, W1 is to W3 equal to 5:4:3. So, this is the condition given the problem. Now heat engine 1, eta 1 equal to W1 by Q1, which is T1 minus T2 divided by T1. So W1 equal to Q1 minus Q2. So Q1, heat supplied to the heat engine Q1 equal to Q2 plus W1. So W1 divided by Q1 equal to Q2 plus W1. So Q2 plus W1 equal to T1 minus T2 divided by T1. So the W1 divided by Q2 plus W1 equal to T1 minus T2 divided by T1. Now similarly, Q2 plus W1, take the reciprocal, Q2 divided by W1 plus W1 equal to T1 minus T2. So Q2 by W1 plus 1, so rearranging, Q2 by W1 plus W1 by W1 equal to 1, equal to T1 divided by T1 minus T2. So Q2 by W1 equal to T1 by T1 minus T2 minus 1, or Q2 by W1, simplifying right hand side, this will be T2 by T1 minus T2. So Q2, heat rejected by the first engine divided by work output of the first engine is equal to T2 by T1 minus T2. So this is the conclusion for heat engine cycle, heat engine 1. Similarly, heat engine 2, eta 2 equal to W2 by Q2, so T2 minus T3 divided by T2. So substituting for Q2 from the previous equation, so Q2 equal to, so the from the previous equation, Q2 equal to W1 into T1 divided by T1 minus T2. So here Q2 is in the denominator, so this will be 1 by W1 into T1 minus T2 divided by T2, which is equal to T2 minus T3 divided by T2. So W2 by W1, which is 4 by 5 into T1 minus T2 equal to T2 minus T3. So T1, T2, T2 is getting cancelled. Now 0.8 into 1000 minus T2 equal to T2 minus T3. Now we have a equation, 800 plus T3 equal to 1.8 times of T2, or T2 equal to 444.4 plus 0.55 times of T3. So we call this equation number 1. So T2 in terms of T3. And W2 equal to Q2 minus Q3. So Q2 equal to, for this heat engine 2 once again, W2 equal to Q2 minus Q3. Q2 equal to Q3 plus W2. So W2 divided by efficiency, W2 divided by Q2 equal to Q3 plus W2 equal to T2 minus T3 divided by T2. Now reciprocal of this equation, Q3 by W, Q3 plus W2 divided by W2 equal to T2 by T2 minus T3, and Q3 by W2 plus 1 equal to, so Q3 by W2 plus W2 by W2 equal to 1 is equal to T2 by T2 minus T3, and Q3 by W2 equal to T2 by T2 minus T3 minus 1. So simplifying the right hand side, this will be T3 by T2 minus T3. So Q3 by W2 equal to T3 by T2 minus T3. Now efficiency of the third engine, W3 by Q3, which is T3 by T3 minus T4 divided by T3. Now we substitute for Q3 from the previous equation. So from Q3 equal to W2 into T3 by T2 minus T3, and Q3 is in the denominator here. So W3 into 1 by W2 plus T2 minus T3 divided by T3 is equal to T3 minus T4 divided by T3. So W3 by W2 equal to 3 by 4 into T3 is T3 cancelled. So T2 minus T3 equal to T3 minus T4. Now substituting 0.75 into T2 minus T3 equal to T3 minus 300. So once again 0.75 T2 equal to 1.75 T3 minus 300, and substituting for T2 here 0.75 into 444.4 plus 0.55 times of T3 equal to 1.75 T3 minus 300. So calculating, doing the calculation, 0.75 into 444.4 equal to 333.3 into 0.75 into 0.55 equal to 0.4125 T3 equal to 1.75 T3 minus 300. So solving this equation, T3 equal to 474.4 Kelvin, and T2 equal to 470, use this equation, any one of the equation, T2 equal to 444.4 plus 0.55 times of T3, so this equal to 705 0.3 Kelvin. So T2 equal to 705.3 Kelvin and T3 equal to 474.4 Kelvin. So the answer to the problem, intermediate temperature T2 equal to 705.3 Kelvin and T3 equal to 474.4 Kelvin. And problem number 19, a heat engine receives 800 kilojoules of heat from a reservoir at 1000 Kelvin and reject heat 400 kilojoules of heat at 400 Kelvin. If the surrounding is at 300 Kelvin, calculate the first and second law efficiency of the heat engine. And this is from Anna University question paper, May 2016. So, we are given Q1 equal to 800 kilojoules, T1 equal to 1000 Kelvin, Q2 equal to 400 Kelvin, 400 kilojoules, T2 equal to 400 Kelvin, and the surrounding temperature is TO equal to 300 Kelvin. The Carnot efficiency of the heat engine. So, Carnot efficiency equal to 1 minus T2 by T1, which is 1 minus 400 divided by 1000 equal to 0.6, which is 60%. First law efficiency of the engine, first law efficiency Q1 minus Q2 divided by Q1. So, 800 minus 400 divided by 800 equal to 0.5 equal to 50%. And second law efficiency by definition, eta 2 equal to eta 1 divided by the first law efficiency divided by the Carnot cycle efficiency, or which is 0.5 divided by 0.6 equal to 0.83, which is 83%. So, we stop here. So, these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. So, you can also refer to it for additional information or additional problems. So, if you have any queries, you write to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer. So, thank you for watching. We'll meet again.